So you want to stream drums or another instrument onto Twitch or Facebook or YouTube? I've got you. There's a lot to know and it can be complicated, but this is why I'm here. This is going to be a two-part video. Today I'm going to talk about the gear, so stay tuned to see how you can stream music to Twitch. So what you just saw was a short clip from my Twitch streams, which I do every Tuesday, Thursday and Sunday. Make sure to check them out. Cheap little plug, I know. Just to show you what you can achieve just with a little bit of knowledge and understanding of gear and what you need to do. But there's one thing I need to do real quick. Seeing as this is a YouTube video, could I be any more YouTube? The first thing I'm going to show you is just this little diagram I made of the order in which you need to do things. So first of all, you have your source, then the capture, input, PC, OBS, and then your streaming platform of choice, whether it's Twitch, Facebook, or YouTube. Section by section, I'm going to go through these and tell you what gear you'll need in each link of that chain. So first of all is source, which is obvious. So if you're streaming drums, you need your drum kit or your guitar or whatever it is that you're streaming. So next is going to be capture. We need to somehow capture this to be able to put it on stream. So for the drum kit, microphones, and then cameras like what I'm recording on now to make this video. You're going to need something to film it, to film you, and also to pick up the audio. Another very important thing in terms of capture is lighting. Good lighting is what makes any camera look good. Whether it's a cheap camera or an expensive camera, if your shot isn't lit very well, it won't look very good. So I use the Godox SL60W, which is a fantastic video light. They're reasonably priced as well. Good lights is a must. Something that's not a must but does look cool is practical lighting, like my blue and pink lights behind me. Links in the description. Next is what I called input. So that will be things like your audio interface for all of the microphones, and then also capture cards, which takes the image from your camera and is able to feed it into your PC. Then next we would have a PC or a laptop or whatever, something to put all of this information into, so then you can use it to go on to the next stage, which is OBS. So OBS is open broadcast software. It's a, how would you describe it, Raina? It's basically an amazing free piece of software that you input all of this information to, and then that sends it to Twitch, YouTube, or Facebook. And then last of all, you just need an account on said platform that you're going to use. So like I said, I stream on Twitch. All of these steps are going to work equally for YouTube and Facebook. So each of these sections, I'm now going to tell you the exact gear that I'm using. However, it's not important to obviously have the exact same stuff I have. By no means I'm saying I have the best gear. This is just the gear that I have. And I'm going to give you the specifics. So if you're brand new to this, it gives you a stepping stone so you kind of know what to look for. Plus, all of the links to all of this stuff will be down in the description. So first of all is my drum kit. It's a Tama Hyperdrive drum kit. I don't think you really need to know all of this for this video, so I'm going to kind of skip over this, but you know your gear, that's fine. What's important is the next step, which is capture. So for the drums, we need microphones, right? So on the kit, I've got the SE Electronics V-Series drum microphones, which includes the award-winning V-Kick and V-Beat microphone. Amazeballs. There'll be a link to this stuff down below for you. So microphones is very important. Obviously, you need to be able to pick up the audio that you want to send to OBS and then to your stream. For the video side of things, the main camera that I'm using right now is also my main angle for the stream. It's a Canon 80D with the Canon 10 to 18 millimeter wide angle lens on it. With something like drums, it's really important to have a wide angle lens to capture as much of the kit at once. So you'll notice from the clip that I played at the start, that shot, you've got pretty much everything in there, whereas if you had a much whereas if you had a lens which wasn't as wide, you wouldn't be capturing as much stuff at once. So I have a second camera as well, which is a Sony A5100. Beast of a little camera. It's great. I use it as my side angle. Now, speaking of cameras, here's something that's really important to note. You don't obviously need a big fancy DSLR camera like I'm using and something like the Sony as your side camera. You can just do this all with a regular webcam, like a Logitech webcam or what have you. But if you are going to get a DSLR as your main streaming camera, there's something really important you need to check, which is that the camera can do a clean 8 HDMI output. What this means is when you send the HDMI signal from the camera to your capture card to the computer, you're going to get a clean image like you're seeing now, with none of the information on screen telling you like your battery life and, you know, the ISO and all that information. You want it to be clean. So most DSLRs can do this, but it's definitely worth checking. The second thing to look out for, which is something that I'm hoping to upgrade to soon, is with Canon cameras, you cannot have the autofocus turned on and have a clean HDMI output. So the only way you're going to get the clean output with the Canon is by turning off the autofocus, setting your focus, and just set and forget. Now, that's fine, and I guess I don't really need my main angle to keep following me, but I kind of would like it to. So this is where another brand like Sony would come in hand, because Sony cameras do have clean HDMI output with the autofocus turned on. So my secondary camera, the A5100, can have autofocus and clean HDMI. So this isn't massively important. I just thought I'd point that out to you, because not many people do mention that, and it might be quite important for you. Maybe if you're playing guitar or if you're going to be moving around a lot, you want that focus to follow you to add to the quality of your stream. Okay, so next we've got the section I called input. So this will be taking those microphones and cameras and how do we feed them to the PC. So for microphones, you're going to need an audio interface. The one that I use is the Behringer XR18. It's good bang for buck. Excuse the pun, because we're talking about drums. I know that was really lame. You get 18 input and output for, like, I can't remember, like, there'll be a price on screen, but I think they're about £300, and it's fantastic. It also has a digital built-in mixer, so on my phone, I can control everything that I need to, so the levels, I can EQ everything, I can add compression, and it can all be done in one unit, which is so handy and efficient for the stream. So if you're brand new to this, or if you've got the money to invest in an interface, I would highly recommend the Behringer XR18. If not, then all you need is a digital USB interface mixer, whatever, that has enough inputs for your drums that can send a USB feed of that signal to your computer. Now for the cameras, you're going to need something called a capture card. So in my case, I'm using an Elgato 4K Camlink. In my case, I'm using an Elgato. Oh my God, I can't even speak. What I'm using is the Elgato Camlink 4K for my main camera, which is a great little USB device. You send your HDMI feed to that, and then USB to the computer. Bob's your uncle, Fanny's your aunt. You've got camera signal on your PC. What am I talking about? And for my second camera, I am looking to upgrade to get a second Camlink, but I'm actually using like a cheap knockoff of the Camlink. The only downside to this one is you're limited to 30 frames per second. The colors aren't quite as well replicated, and it's only up to 1080 output, which is fine because no streaming platform that I know of is bigger than 1080 at the moment. I think the max resolution for Twitch is 1080. So these little things are great. I think I got mine for about £17. Again, links to all this stuff will be in the description. So let me just take a second to thank today's sponsor, which is DistroKid. It is highly likely that if you're watching this video, you are a musician. If you are, you probably make music. Now, you need to get that music online so it can be on all the streaming platforms and that it can be sold to your fans through things like iTunes. iTunes? Is it called Apple Music and iTunes? Are they the same thing? I don't know. Google Play, wherever it is you get your music from, whatever, you can get it on there using DistroKid. There's so many great features that they have on there as well. So you can get your Spotify account verified with that nice little blue tick. You can get your official artist YouTube page. You can make synced lyric videos for Instagram. You can make hyperlink follow. Oh, there's so many good things, which I utilize all the time with DistroKid, and I love it. And Ryan, hey man, what's up?
Have you told them about the 7%?
Yeah, I'm just about to tell them about the
7% link in description.
Yep, 7%.
In the description.
Yeah, and it's in the... Yep.
Oh.
Okay.
You okay, mate? How are things going?
Are you done? Right? Oh. Awesome. All right. I'm sorry. Ryan's constantly just getting involved. He's a bit jealous that I've got a channel and he hasn't. So he tries to get involved with my one. But I think he's gone now. But anyway, please do check out DistroKid. Link in the description. 7% off your first annual subscription. Amazeballs. Thank you so much, DistroKid, for sponsoring this video. The next thing you're going to need is a PC or laptop to connect all of this stuff to. Now, disclaimer, I'm not really a techie guy. I don't know much about this stuff. I had to do a lot of research and also watch a lot of YouTube videos myself to find out what would make a good streaming PC, and there's plenty of good videos to do that. I guess all you really need to know is that having a very good processor and a very good video card is your best friend in this situation. Those are the things that you really need to be looking out for. The specs of my PC will be up here on screen now, and all of the parts will be linked in description. But if you already have a decent laptop, if you already have a gaming PC or whatever, it's worth just checking that your, you know, the thing you already have, I'm sure, will be able to stream. It might just be that you have to knock the quality of your stream down a little bit while you use your streams to save up for a better PC. That's exactly what I did. I started my streams on a potato laptop. In terms of a PC or laptop, as long as you've got really good processor, really good video card, you should be golden. All right, so next what you need to do is download OBS. This is free, it's amazing. There's links to it in the description. We're gonna go more in depth in this in the next part of this series, but for now, all you need to know is download it, install it. Nice. Finally, the last step, probably the easiest one, making an account on the platform that you want to stream to. You probably already have the account. Amazing. If you don't, it's pretty straightforward. Go to Twitch, sign in, log in, sign up, whatever, make an account. Awesome. One last little bonus thing that you might want to get for your stream, which again is not a necessity. You can 100% have a fantastic stream without it, but a lot of people do find it very handy. I really rely on this now for my stream, and it's something also by Elgato called the Stream Deck. It's basically this little thing full of buttons, and you can tell the buttons to do certain things on OBS, which saves you time, and it means you don't have to use your mouse and keyboard. And it sounds lazy, I know. Now I'm saying this, it sounds lazy, but there's way more that you can do with it, and it's a great little gadget to have as a bonus. But again, I'm going to go more into this in the second part of this video, which is where I'm going to show you how we take all of this stuff I've mentioned today and turn it into the stream. So we're going to be opening up OBS, showing you how to get your video files and audio and everything in there, and setting up and streaming it, and it's going to be a good time. It's going to be a good time. So if you want to see that, please do make sure to like the channel, turn on notifications and subscribe. And I'm so tired today, I can't talk. I'm not even going to do a second take of that because I'm getting to that point, you know? So thanks so much for watching, everybody. Really do appreciate it. If you've got any other questions about gear or want me to be a little bit more specific about this stuff, feel free to jump into my Discord. You can ask me anything you want and get to know everyone, and we can talk way more about gear and how to connect it all. But like I said, we're going to be doing all of that in a second part of the video. I stream every Thursday, Tuesday and Sunday. I said that in a weird order on Twitch. Make sure to drop the Twitch a follow. And I will see you guys next time. Thank you so much for watching the video. Hopefully that helped you with knowing what gear... hopefully that helped you with knowing what gear you're going to need. So I'll see you next time for turning this gear into a stream. And as per usual, whatever you're doing today, go out and smash it. One of you guys asked me what my view of the stream is. So this is it. This is what I see when I'm streaming. I'm staring at this freaking bright light the whole time. I've got a mic all up in my grill. All you lovely guys are over here in the chat on my OBS screen. So yeah, that's pretty much it, mate. Hopefully the curiosity is worth the hype. I don't know what I'm saying. I'll see you guys next time.